Good morning, children of God.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship this morning at Emmanuel Lutheran. It is a joy that we are together this morning on Palm Sunday. Happy Palm Sunday. Our announcements this morning are, if you have not yet downloaded our bulletin for today, please go to luthwash.org. luthwash.org, and you will find our Palm Sunday bulletin for today there. Also, stay connected to us live streamed. We will be having pastor time or story time with Pastor Maureen at 10 o'clock. So join us every day at 10 o'clock as I read a Bible story for the children and adults as well. Today, in the prayers of the saints, I will be remembering Daryl Dillon, who had died on St. Patrick's Day, and he is the grandpa of Molly Ziviak, and so we will be remembering Daryl in the prayers of the saints this morning. What a joy to be together today on Palm Sunday. Welcome, welcome to Emmanuel Lutheran, and know that the church is always open, because you are the church, and Christ is constantly working through you. So the church never closes, but we are thrilled that we are together this morning. So let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Hear God's love. We hear God's love for the world and for us through forgiveness, scripture, preaching, liturgy, and song. Hear God's love. Holy God, open our ears to hear and our hearts to be transformed by Christ's words of love to and for the world. Amen. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is present, who gives life, who calls into existence the things that do not exist. Amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done, things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with the power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. Together we sing, Prepare the Royal Highway. Thank you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the world. Lord, have mercy. For peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this holy house, and for all who offer their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Sovereign God, you have established your rule in the human heart through the servanthood of Jesus Christ. By your Spirit, keep us in the joyful procession of those who with their tongues confess Jesus as Lord, and with their lives praise him as Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now hear the word of the God.
The first reading today is from Isaiah, the 50th chapter. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen to those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pull out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint and know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps us. Who will declare me guilty? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read the psalm responsively in Psalm chapter 31, starting with verse 9. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly.
For my life is wasted with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed.
I am the scorn of all my enemies, a disgrace to my neighbors, a dismay to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they avoid me.
Like the dead, I am forgotten out of mind. I am useless as a broken pot.
For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me, and they plot to take my life.
But as for me, I have trusted you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love.
The second reading today is from Philippians chapter 2. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited. But he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Together we sing the gospel acclamation. This morning comes to us from St. Matthew, the 21st chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethpage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied with a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this: the Lord needs them, and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet, Jesus, from Nazareth in Galilee." The gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Well, this is the third Sunday that Emmanuel and churches all over the country must social distance and rely on alternative ways to proclaim the mighty and powerful word of God. These weeks have been filled with disappointment as one activity after another are canceled. Activities that we have looked so forward to and longed for. Activities that are special to us. Confirmation, First Communion, dance recitals, school and all school activities, prom. And do we know what's happening with graduations? Even weddings and funerals are getting creative so their happenings can occur. And here it is, Palm Sunday, a day of great excitement. And Emmanuel has Mike and Sarah and me. And behind me lay 100 palms at the altar. Yet disappointment is not new to the church, to the disciples of Jesus. They are pumped. They are excited. They know Jesus is the long-awaited Messiah, and they're headed to Jerusalem to take on the authorities and have Jesus throw his godly weight around to restore Israel to its former glory. Yay! We're headed to Jerusalem! But wait, there's a problem right from the start. Disappointment. They're headed in through the back gate, the east entrance. What? Headed in through the front gate, the west entrance, was Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor, coming into Jerusalem to keep the iron fist of Rome firmly on that city as it celebrates the holy Passover. Pilate comes riding in with no expenses spared, heavy war horses carrying armed soldiers, foot soldiers marching to the cadence of drums, each displaying their Roman weaponry, swords and shields gleaming in the sun, and banners, Roman banners flapping in the breeze as Pilate comes riding in with a fanfare of power, strength, and authority. There's no question of who's in control. And I suspect Jerusalem was quiet with intimidation as Pilate's parade passed by. Now, at the same time, Jesus comes through the back gate, the east entrance of the city, not on ground-shaking, majestic war horses, but on a pack animal, a plodding, peaceful donkey. And here in St. Matthew, Jesus rides in on a mom donkey with her colt. And Jesus' cheering audience are the blind who now see, the lame who now walk, the hungry who are now satisfied, the ostracized who are now called family, and the oppressed seeking freedom. The crowd, the lost who have put their hope in Jesus, the found who have been following Jesus to this big city from their backwater towns, the crowd cheering their leader on to victory, who will bring about justice and reform from the heavy-handed violence, suffering, and greed imprisoning them now, cheering their Lord with words infuriating to Rome and to the temple elite. Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. The cheering crowd, outsiders to Jerusalem, welcome this stranger to the city as their king, making the path smooth and straight by throwing their cloaks and tree branches onto the ground. Jerusalem's silent crowd knows who enters through the west gate. They know what lies ahead. The cheering crowd knows who enters through the east gate, but they think they know what lies ahead. When the parade from the west, oppression, greed, and bondage, meets the parade from the east, humility, peace, and freedom, a firestorm erupts. And like a stadium wave, the echoes of hosannas, the echoes of blessed name of the Lord, moves through the city, and turmoil overtakes Jerusalem's silence as they respond by shouting, "Who is this?" Jerusalem confronts the crowd's jubilant praises to Jesus. Hosanna! Save us, we pray. Jubilant cheers that identify Jesus as the incoming King, Son of David. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Jerusalem confronts the crowd with a simple question: who is this? In the crowd, fear of the Roman retaliation this parade from the east may start, answers with a retraction of enthusiasm, answers with a skeptical hopelessness. This guy Jesus from Nazareth, he's just a prophet. The parade from the west enters with grandeur and distinct identity of whom is being welcomed. The parade from the east enters with a slow walking donkey with a foal by her side. Crescendos to tree branches and cloaks carpeting the road with triumphant cheers of praise and hope, and fizzles to skeptical hopefulness, and the crowd disperses, leaving a man alone on a donkey with 12 confused friends. Skeptical hopefulness leads to great disappointment as the week does not play out as the crowd and the disciples hope and expected. Maybe we too enter this week with skeptical hopefulness. The virus is keeping us inside and separated. The medical world and essential businesses are fatigued, yet tirelessly forge on, sacrificing themselves for the sake of complete strangers. Maybe skeptical hopefulness will continue to lead to disappointment as isolation orders consume the weeks and rescheduling becomes a calendar nightmare. And with disappointment, we cry, from where will our help come? Who will save us? We enter this week with a humble parade from the east, where the guest of honor, Jesus, hears our praises of hosannas. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hears those praises turn to silence. silence, where the guest of honor, Jesus, promises to be with us and for us through bread and wine, commands us to love one another just as Jesus loves us, where the guest of honor is arrested, beaten, and crucified, where the guest of honor, Jesus, forgives our sins, for we know not what we do. Where the guest of honor, Jesus, commends his spirit to the Father and takes his last breath. And all of Jerusalem, the crowd following Jesus, the 12 disciples, you and me, ask, who is this? Amen. We continue with the blessing of the palms. Now, we don't have palms, but in a way we do have palms. Each and every one of us has palms. We have these palms that give praise and honor, these palms that give joy and exaltation. And so, people of God, we will bless not only these palms, but we will bless your palms as we give joy to God. We continue with the bulletin. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
Let us pray. I invite all people to raise their palms. We praise and thank you, O God, for the great acts of love by which you have redeemed us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. On this day, he entered the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph and was acclaimed Son of God and King of Kings by those who scattered their garments and branches of palm in his path. We ask you to bless these branches and our palms, and grant that we may hail him as our Lord and King, and follow him with perfect confidence. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And together we sing, all glory, Lord, and honor.
Israel.
he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ, living together in trust and hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. We confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Turning our hearts to God, who is gracious and merciful, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. After each prayer petition, I will say, "Hear us, O God," and I ask that you respond with, "Your mercy is great." God of mercy, awaken your church to new proclamations of your faithfulness. By your Spirit, give us bold and joyful words to speak, that we sustain the weary with the message of your redemption. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of mercy, quiet the earth where it trembles and shakes. Protect vulnerable ecosystems, threatened habitats, and endangered species. Prosper the work of scientists, engineers, and researchers who find ways to restore creation to health and wholeness. Grant comfort and healing to those affected by all disasters, especially tornadoes, so they may come to know new life through you. Hear us, O God. God of mercy, drive away fear and anger that cause us to turn against one another. Give courage to leaders who seek liberation for the oppressed. Bring peace and hope to those who are in prison and those who face execution. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of mercy, send your saving help to all who suffer abuse, insult, discrimination, or contempt. Heal the wounded. Comfort the dying. Bring peace to those suffering chronic or terminal illness. Quell our fears over COVID-19. Heal those who are suffering from it, and grant us wisdom to contain and prevent its hold on us. Give courage to those who are tending to the sick. Tend to all who cry out for relief. We pray especially for those we name before you now, in our hearts or spoken out loud. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of mercy, we pray for all who prepare to worship this Holy Week while being in social distancing. In all things, show us the way that you call us to die to self, to live for you, and to give ourselves for the sake of others. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of mercy, when we breathe our last, you raise us to eternal life. With all your witnesses in heaven and on earth, especially Daryl Dillon, let us boldly confess the name of Jesus Christ, our resurrection and our hope. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
According to your steadfast love, O God, hear these and all our prayers, as we commend them to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share the peace of Christ with one another. The peace of Christ be with you always, Sarah. The peace of Christ be with you always, Mike.
And also with you.
During this time of social distancing, we continue to give God our thanks and praise through our tithes and offerings of thanksgiving for the mission of the church, including the care of those in need. We invite you to please mail your checks to Emmanuel Lutheran. Call the church and ask for Simply Giving automatic withdrawal from your accounts. Or give online through our website, luthwash.org. We'll take a moment to receive your offerings. Generous host, you set a table where we feast as friends. Prepare us to witness to your goodness with every gift you have given us to share, that all people may know your peace through Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen. We give thanksgiving for the word of God. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, holy God. For by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. By your word you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Send your spirit of truth, O God, rekindle your gifts within us, renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love for the sake of a world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. forever and ever. Amen. Children of God, you are deeply loved. Receive God's blessing. Christ has no body but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes in which he looks compassion on this world. Yours are the feet in which he walks to do good. Yours are the hands in which he blesses all this world. Yours are the hands, yours are the feet, yours are the eyes. You are Christ's body. Christ has no body now on earth but yours. Holy God, speaking, spoken, and inspiring, bless you, unbind you, and send you in love and peace. Amen. Together we sing our sending hymn, You Are Mine. Love and serve the Lord. Amen. Amen.